Okay, thanks for clicking. This is Yud Gimel Tishrei during the leap year, so it's going to be regular year because it's going to be the start of the new year in 6 days. But this is Yud Gimel Kislev, Kuntres Achron, the fifth and I believe final essay. Let us understand how this applies to the details of the laws that never occur at all. There are many such laws, and possibly never actually existed, and certainly will not come to pass in the time to come. For example, the details laws of Pigul and the like. It is known that every prohibited thing in the world has a source and a root of life in the Klipot. Otherwise, it cannot exist in this world without the flow from above. Even one who crinkles his hair, talking about his beard hair, and the like, receives his life force at that moment from the spiritual chambers of the Klipot, as explained in the Zohar. I'm actually not sure if the intent there is that he crinkles them on Shabbos, or that he crinkles them for the sake of, to make himself beautiful, like it's about Yosef HaTzadik, that he was given Musar because he wasn't able to do that, but it's some kind of minor transgression. But he's saying even at that time, he's getting his vitality from the Klipot. Therefore, even the particular prohibitions that never became practical issues in the physical world, still the roots of their life force do actually exist in the spiritual chambers of the Klipot. Even the particular instances that possibly never did and never will actually occur, for example, errors and unwitting misdeeds, like when tithing erroneously, calling the ninth sheep the tenth and the like, the kind of eventuality that cannot be deliberate and thereby cause a klipa to light upon it. Possibly in these circumstances, it does not exist in the chambers of the klipot. Now there's a note from the Tzemach Tzedek, his grandson. It appears to me that the Alter Rebbe uses the word possibly, implying uncertainty, because unwitting errors derive from Noga. It may therefore be said that their origin is in the chambers of Noga. In any event, it does exist. That's, I believe, the end of the note. At least keeping in mind the distinction between the sacred and the profane, and the supreme wisdom that issued and descended in this detail to Moses at Sinai. As in the expression, whatever teaching any seasoned student will one day innovate was taught to Moses at Sinai. Likewise, all the detailed queries of Rab Yirmiyahu, who posed so many hypothetical possibilities that he was escorted from the house of study, as the Gemara relates. Obviously, his queries involved situations that were entirely unlikely to ever take place. And detailed queries such as, if she wrapped him in chapter 4 of Chulin. For the extension of the supreme wisdom that is vested in the laws of Torah is infinite, since the infinite is actually clothed within it. Every particular of the law is a gate drawn from the supreme wisdom, which founded the daughter and is clothed in it. And from Malchut, Chachma is drawn and invested in Bria, Tzira, and Asiya. It is known that the nurture of the Klipot derives from the hinder part of the 10th Sphere of Holiness, and more precisely from the garment of the 10th Sphere of the Bria, Tzira, and Asiya, meaning not its field itself. And yet more precisely, they derive their nurture from the garments of Yetzira and Asiya, now it's leading up Bria, that are intermingled with Klipot. For as is known, their nurture derives from the state of garments, meaning the two lowest worlds. Through the study of the laws in speech and in thought, they become separate and distinct from the sacred. Thus it is stated in Tikkunim and Raim Nehemna, to separate, etc., the Klipot from holiness through Torah study. This accords with what is known concerning the teaching of our sages, in answer to the prophet's query, why was the land destroyed? For they did not recite the blessing before Torah study. The separation is effected by drawing down the infinite light into the supreme wisdom clothed in them. Through Chachma they are sorted out, through the infinite light that is within it. This light is drawn into the supreme wisdom by the supernal likeness of man, who is also occupied with the laws above. In its source, in Nukva of Zah, of Bria, Yetzirah, and Nesiyah. Thus we can understand the requirements that every Nefesh Ruach Neshama fulfill all 613 commandments in thought, speech, and deed, meaning the details of the laws. They must be reincarnated to fill the Torah in its simple meaning, allusions, homiletics, and secrets, in order to sort out and refine all that pertains to them from among the 288 sporks that constitute the complete structure of man, with the 613 categories, general and particular. But in the time to come, when the refinement is culminated, the study of Torah will be in the form of do good alone. Its purpose will be to elevate Nefesh Ruach Neshama even ever and infinitely higher. And also with regard to the study of the 365 prohibitions, to elevate them to their source, the holy attributes of severity, and to sweeten them through the attributes of kindness that are in the 248 positive commandments, and to fuse them. The entire Torah is thus eternal in general and in detail. For even the individual laws of the 365 prohibitions are branches of the Torah's general statements. All of them have a source above in the five holy attributes of severity, just as the 365 prohibitions themselves, as they are above, in the state of blood that animates the organs of the vessels of Zah. I promise you, in 6 days, this becomes a manual of the soul, and it gets very exciting and very useful. It's not Kabbalah-based. There's an interesting point that, where was it? That, Okay, I forget what it was. Anyway, may God Almighty bless us in everything that we do, and then we merit the time to come now where we're gonna. You can be reincarnated many times just to do every single one of the 613 mitzvahs. So if a mitzvah comes to you, you shouldn't delay. You should do it right away, because it could be for this reason your whole incarnation happened. And if you miss the mitzvah, it's like you're going to have to come back down into this gross physical world and start all over again for no good reason. Always run to do as many mitzvahs as you can. Any mitzvah that presents itself, do it speedily. This could be the whole reason for your reincarnation. Thanks so much, and God bless.